The topic today is mitigating DDoS attacks. It's my pleasure to be speaking with Malcolm Palmore. He's the Assistant Special Agent in charge of the FBI office in San Francisco. Hi, I'm Tom Field, Vice President of Editorial with Information Security Media Group. Malcolm, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me, Tom.
To start out with, tell us a little bit about your role within the cyber division in San Francisco, please.
Sure. Tom, I report directly to the Special Agent in charge of the FBI field office here in San Francisco. My responsibilities deal directly with the FBI's response to cyber matters, and so we're responsible for those actions in and around the San Francisco region.
So give us a little bit of context here. What are the types of cases that your division typically gets involved with?
So for the FBI, cyber breaks down into two main categories, criminal intrusions and our actions in the national security realm. And so the cases range everywhere from simple DDoS attacks, criminal intrusions where bad actors intend to introduce malware or things of that nature, and then the national security side of the house, which deals specifically with threats that might emanate from countries that intend to do us harm on the national security spectrum.
Now, you said simple DDoS attacks. Is there any such thing as simple DDoS
attacks
anymore?
Not really. That's an oversimplification.
That's a topic I wanted to go into with you, distributed denial of service attacks. In 2012, 2013, we saw a spate of those against some of the largest financial institutions. So give us some background on where the FBI typically entered the picture with DDoS attacks.
Right. So this is a ongoing developing field for us. The FBI continues to emphasize the fact that our response to cyber matters is not only elevated, but among the top priorities for the FBI. Our response starts from the notification phase. Oftentimes, because of the relationships that we have with our private sector partners, we'll get a call directly from victim companies notifying us of attacks. We basically triage that information and determine what resources we need to bring to bear in order to help our private sector partners mitigate those attacks. We gather information and hopefully put ourselves in a position to identify tools, methods of operating for the bad actors, and we try as best we can to put that information together and push it out to others like ourselves who are occupying space in the cyber threat industry.
Now, I like what you're saying about partnership, because we've heard typically about industry partnerships, you know, financial institutions talking with one another, working with the FSISAC, or working with the vendor community. Give us a sense of how the FBI partners with the private sector to help in, for instance, DDoS.
Right, so there's many efforts that are underway by the FBI and others to try as best we can to cover down on the cyber threat. The real issue is about resources. Although the FBI has a tremendous number of resources, we oftentimes find ourselves limited due to geography or the ability to bring massive numbers of individuals to address a particular problem set. So the real way of tackling that is to create partnerships both in law enforcement and the intelligence community, but the big factor in that is creating partnerships with our private sector partners. It's a way to get us closer to the problem set. They are going to see much more than we will of these issues, and the closer we can get to them, the faster we're able to receive information related to the attacks and threats that they're seeing on a day-to-day basis, and the better we are in terms of our preparation and preparing for these attacks and then gathering that information and trying to make the private sector folks smarter about how they respond to these issues.
So in terms of one of these partnerships, give us a sense of what the FBI brings to the table and what you need your partners to bring to the table.
Right, so there's a lot of folks operating in this space, if you will. A lot of government agencies, folks within the intelligence community and private sector partners. What we try and do, specifically here in San Francisco, and as I told you, I operate out of the South Bay region, we try and create direct relationships with the major players in this arena and all the way down to the minor players as well. So we're talking about direct one-on-one contact. In the event that a threat event happens, we'll actually put agents on the ground, respond to the company, and with their consent, gather information as appropriate as it relates to the tools and the methods that were used to start the attack.
How do you measure the success of a partnership like this? I mean, I suppose ultimately it results in an arrest or a successful investigation.
Well, it's difficult to measure because the metrics for this are still developing. So I would say one way that we measure it is by knowing that when the next attack happens, that we get that phone call from our partners in the private sector. That's one way of determining that, one, that there is a trust that's developing between us and them, and that they recognize that we bring a fair tool set to the table when these threats take place. The other way that we determine if we're covered down on this is if in the intelligence community we recognize that we are already in possession of information as it relates to the threats once we dig in and figure out exactly what was involved in it. So it constantly developing, but again, this is a major priority for the FBI, so we're trying to put as many skilled resources to the problem as we can.
Now, this is new for both sides, really, for the private sector and for the FBI. Do you have to overcome some preconceptions to really have successful partnerships with the private sector?
Of course we do. I mean, we're dealing with an emerging threat in a technically specific area of operations, and due to some issues that have arisen over the course of, say, the past year, it makes it a little difficult to establish those really close bonds with folks in the private sector. I mean, they want to be assured that that we're dealing with them in an up and up fashion, and so our job is to be as open as we possibly can in dealing with them.
Mm-hmm. What would you say you draw from the experience as lessons learned or as best practices that you then can apply to other work within the cyber division?
Yeah, well, the best practice really is to make sure that we're in constant dialogue with our private sector partners. The more that we communicate with them, the more that we interact with them, you know, like this conference specifically, here at the RSA conference, the more that we interact with them, I think the better position we are to respond to their needs. It's when we go off in a vacuum and operate and allow them to operate in a vacuum that that we find it much more difficult to cover the ground on this. But our answer to that is more dialogue, more interaction, and hopefully it'll better position us to be ready for threats in the future.
And there will be threats in the future.
There will be.
Malcolm, I appreciate your time and your insight today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tom.
The topic has been mitigating DDoS threats, and I've been talking with Malcolm Palmore. He's the Assistant Special Agent in Charge of the FBI Division in San Francisco. Thank you very much.